It is basically a lecture I'm making for company law, and it is a basically basic lecture, and it is related to what is a company and how does it function. Basically, I want to share that company is an artificial person, and it takes money from public for doing business, and company is owned by shareholder, and it works in the interest of the shareholders. There is a famous line called, there is a divorce between the management and the ownership. And management and ownership means what? Management is different than the owners. Owners are shareholders, and management is directors. And directors are appointed by the shareholders. Some of the directors can become share. Some of the shareholders can become directors. And moreover. Now the point is, if it is a public company or it is a private company or it is one person company, this I'm talking about like the types of the company. Although there are many types of company like private company, public company, and lot of other, but what I would say, private company is a closely held company. Closely held company means a company which is basically meant for running the business, and it is for known people, small group. Thereafter, private company, the minimum members are 2, maximum members are 200, and it is closely held company. It cannot take money from public, but a public company has got a wide coverage. There are 7 shareholders minimum, and maximum there is no limit. And moreover, children, public company is a large size company, and people can contribute small amount, and it can collect huge amount because it has no restriction to borrow money from public. It has no restriction. It can issue preference shares, it can issue equity shares, it can issue debentures all among the public. But remember this thing, that when it is a public company means which is borrowing money from the public. When it is a public company, then it has a lot of pressure of the government because there is a compliance. Why government word and the interference word? I always say this because the government says you are borrowing money from public, and we are the caretaker of the public because government protects the interest. Now, you know, children, when you live in a country, suppose if you live here, and you have some property, you have some money in the bank. So who takes care of your money? Government, no. Government is like various institutions who give you a pro who gives you protection. So here, if it is a public company, government says, please make it listed, follow the laws, make it listed, and follow the guidelines of SEBI, Security Exchange Board of India. Do not cheat the people. Follow corporate governance guideline, and don't cheat the people. And there are a lot of restrictions on public company. So if somebody asks you, it is a basic lecture, what is a company? We say, it's a company which borrows money from public and thousands of people. I'm talking about the public company. And it borrows money from thousands of people. And then it does business. It earns money. Profit is there. And it borrows money. There is profit. And then profit is shared among by the members, having paid the director's remuneration. It happens. It happens in the case of a public company. But private company has got a small setup. You know, when I'm saying that there is a restriction of 200 shareholders, you can understand on your own that a small group, 200 has become, it is recently, it has changed. Recently, a few years back. Otherwise, the number was earlier restricted to a small number like 50 or something like this. So, and before that, it was 10 or 20. Achha, it was in partnership. Okay. So earlier, this number was less than 200. So nowadays, it is 200. And there is a restriction in private company to borrow money from public. Now, the point is, what is the meaning of public? Public means anyone who is not known to you can give you money. And you just give an advertisement by following the guideline and the person gives you money in the form of preference shares or debentures or equity shares. But the core, you know, the main party who gives money and who has got a role in decision making are equity shareholders. So what is a company? Come to the point again. A company is an artificial person created by law, having a separate legal entity. Common seal is optional. Perpetual succession. Members may come, members may go. But company goes on forever. And it is a type of the company which is meant mainly for doing the business. And there are various types of company, but three types are more very popular. One is private company, second is public company, and third is OPC, one-person company. And private company, as I told you, and there is another lecture I have made, you can watch the difference between public and private company. But here I just thought of sharing something basic about the company. And company is a limited liability. Remember, this is the most important feature of a joint stock company, that the liability of the company is limited. And if company is wound up, liquidated, only that much money will go waste, maximum what shareholder has invested in the company. This is called limited liability. And limited liability is always gives a protection to the investor. He says, yeah, at least my house, my personal belonging are not attached to it. So this is called limited liability. Okay. And artificial person, it is a body corporate. What is artificial person? Which has got a identity in the eyes of law, but the person is not made up biologically. Company is a person, but artificial, invisible. And it is run by the people, because ultimately the human being have got a brain. They have got like the sense to run the company. So those human being can be board of directors or some other people. But company has got an intellectual. Company is an intellect. Like company's intellectual brains are basically directors who are appointed by the shareholders. And it works on a democratic pattern. What is democratic pattern? You remember how the country is run. If Narendra Modi ji is running our country, then Modi ji is given vote by the shareholders. So he is ruling our country. And all the members of parliament have been duly selected from their constituencies. Same logic here. When it is a company and it borrows money from public, then shareholders come into power, they cast vote and select few small team of directors who run the company on their behalf. We call them board of directors. And then if it is a public company, the board of directors are 15, minimum are 3, And they can extend the number. There are certain compliance, but 15 is a popular number. And those board of directors are the management of the company. They run the company, and on they present their report to the shareholder in the annual general meeting. And this is how company goes further. But the basic thing is, remember that it runs business, it does business, it takes money. Money you take, there is a term called economic activity, profit motive. What is business? Business has got a very wide range. Business is running business for profit. And who are the people who are contributing? Shareholders mainly. Who are the main contributors? Equity shareholder. And they run the business themselves. No, they choose director. Sometimes they can themselves become director. And there is another party called promoter. Promoter brings the company into existence. It is a line set for the promoter. That promoter is the person in whose mind the company's idea is conceived. You know, the company comes through brain of the promoter. Then he executes the idea, and this promoter then selects director. Sometime he himself become a director. Then he is a main contributory sometime, and he may be subscribers to memorandum. Subscribers to memorandum means there are two documents when a company is incorporated called memorandum and articles of association. And those two documents are the basis of registration, incorporation of a company. And that those two documents are submitted with the registrar of company, who gives registration to the company. And then company gets certificate of incorporation. And if it is a joint stock company and it is a public limited company, then it can issue shares after doing some compliances. And recently one law is brought into this picture, that company has to get its office verified, and directors have to make an assurance to the registrar that all the subscribers to memorandum have paid the money. Then company is given the permission to start the business. But the basic birthday of the company is the day when certificate of incorporation is issued to the company. Okay. And when company comes into existence, it is governed by company law. First of all, you have to see whether it is doing the business or not. It is public company or private company. Most of the time I'm talking about the public company. Then board of directors are selected. They start functioning, take money from public, and money is invested into various projects. Whatever board of directors decide. And then every year the company closes the books and declares the dividend. This is a normal meaning of a joint stock company. Remember the characteristics of the company. It is a separate body corporate, artificial person, and created by law, separate entity, perpetual succession, common seal, share capital, limited liability. And these are the characteristics created by law and has to comply with the guidelines. Again and again, I want to make you realize that government interferes in the affairs of the public company. Why? Because government says that we are the caretaker, the word I use, or we are the watchmen of the public, and law and order maintenance is our duty. So if you are cheating the people, innocent investors, we are not going to forgive you. Then we are going to punish the culprit. This is a basic concept of the company. And more compliances are available when it is a public company. Less compliances, more privileges are available if it is a private company. You know, when company is not borrowing money from public in huge amount, and there are small, closely held people, so nobody can interfere in the affairs. If suppose there is a businessman in your area, he says, I invest money on my own. Why are you interfering in my affairs? I'm a person who is taking risk, investing money and doing business. Now, why do you interfere? So this kind of approach is also kept into consideration by the government. But government says, if If you will not follow the rules of the company law, we are not going to spare you. And don't cheat innocent investor. Whom are we referring to as investor? Those shareholders who have bought money, who have bought shares, invested money in the company, lent their money to the company, they have become shareholder. Now company is running business from that capital, what company has borrowed from those shareholders. It was an of our children, a basic meaning. So I just thought that I should just share.